Today on our 2018 Nissan Rogue, we're going to be installing the CURT Class III 2-inch Trailer Hitch Receiver, part number C13204. This Class III 2-inch receiver hitch is going to be great for hooking up your trailer, bike rack, cargo carrier, or any other of your favorite hitch-mounted accessories. As you can see here, the cross tube's hidden behind the bumper, so you're only going to be able to see the receiver tube, so it's going to flow in nicely with the vehicle. This 2-inch by 2-inch receiver hitch is going to work great with just about any of your accessories. Whether it be ball mounts, trailers, or bike racks, it's good to go. It uses a 5/8 hitch pin. Now, this is not included with the hitch, but one can be picked up here at etrailer.com. It uses loop-style safety chain hookups, which will work with just about any style of your chains. It has a reinforced collar, which is going to add to extra durability. It has a 525-pound tongue weight, which is the force going down on top of the receiver tube, and a 3,500-pound gross trailer weight, which is the amount that it can pull behind it. Now, that does include the weight of your trailer, plus anything loaded on it. CURT does recommend that you use a stabilization strap when hauling any non-trailer loads. This is essentially anything that doesn't have wheels. And now I've got some measurements to help you when deciding on accessories. From the ground to the top inside edge of the receiver tube, it's going to measure 14 inches. This is important when deciding if you need a drop or rise when pulling your trailer, or if you need a raised shank for your bike rack. From the center of the hitch pin hole to the edge of the bumper, it's going to measure about 6 inches. This is important to decide if you need an extended shank when using accessories that fold up, such as bike racks or cargo carriers. Now that we've gone over some of the features, let's show you how to get it installed. To begin your installation, you'll need to remove the panels on both sides underneath the vehicle. These panels here and here to allow your hitch to go into place. To remove the panel on the driver's side, remove the clip at the back by the exhaust tip. Another one on the inside here. And we can also set this panel aside as we won't be reinstalling it. And we'll repeat that same process on the other side. Now that our panels are out of the way, we're going to lower down our exhaust. Before you lower your exhaust, you want to put a strap on your suspension and run it up to hold your exhaust from falling down too far to prevent any damage from occurring. To remove the exhaust, you just need to pry off the rubber hangers here. A little bit of spray silicone will help remove these hangers a lot easier. After you give it a little soak, you just need to pry it off of either side, whichever one's easier for you to get on. There's one on the other side we'll need to take off as well. And that'll let our exhaust come down some. There is a third hanger here in the back that you can also remove if you need some additional movement dropping it down to make it easier to get your hitch up in there. The tow hook on the passenger side then must be removed. That's held in by 4 18-millimeter head bolts. So we'll take those out now. And after you've got your last bolt out, just set this aside as we won't be reinstalling it either. Now it's a good idea to use some spray lubricant and a little wire brush. You can pick this up here at etrailer.com. Clean out the bolt holes to make sure you don't hit any burrs or dirt gives you trouble getting the bolts in. And you can do this on both sides just to make sure everything's cleaned out. And now with an extra set of hands, we'll put our hitch into place. We'll start by getting our driver's side over the exhaust and then pushing up our passenger side. Once you get a bolt started on each side, the hitch will support itself so you can install the remaining hardware. You want to put your conical tooth washer on your bolt with the teeth facing away from the head of the bolt and thread it up into place. Tighten down all of your hardware with a 19-millimeter socket. Then torque your bolts to the specification in your instructions. And do that with your remaining hardware. And now you can reinstall your exhaust. Just simply push it back into place over those studs. And remove your strap, and you're ready to hook up your trailer and hit the road. And that completes our installation of the CURT Class III 2-inch Trailer Hitch Receiver, on our 2018 Nissan Rogue.
Thanks for watching, and click the link in our description below to shop, learn more, or visit us at etrailer.com. And leave us a comment if you have any questions.